ticket in the lottery. I picked all the right numbers, got the wrong week. My lady luck is on.
Happy Homebrew Wednesday.
Yes, happy Homebrew Wednesday.
This is a big Homebrew Wednesday.
Yes.
Indeed. So we just got back from none other than the Great American Beer Festival. And we're gonna be cracking some beverages here. And our little cups, you got a cup, give me a cup. And what we've got here is some Maharaja from Avery Brewing. Yes, we were there. This bottle was given to us from BH Brewing. And MaximAvs gave us none other than
dun, dun, dun.
Ooh, the big yes. Official BrewTubers opener, baby. That's awesome.
Freaking awesome.
So while we're cracking this, we went to BH Brewing's house, and who were we there with?
Oh, well, we were there with
Immolauteus.
DJtheChef.
Yeah.
DJtheChef, Immolauteus, and MaximAvs.
Yeah.
And, of course, BH himself.
Yes.
It was
awesome.
Awesome.
Some of the nicest guys you'll ever meet in your lives. Truly, truly. Max even joined us at the show with his wife. BH Brewing met us at the bus station with family in tow, his wife, his kids, and his parents-in-law.
Gave us the grand tour right down to the convention center, hung out a little bit. We could have not asked for a better trip. You guys made it awesome.
So
we thank you.
We got to do a little cheers to this with our Avery Maharaja. Is it any better than that?
Salute to you,
salute,
my friends.
Prost.
Now, Dad, this was a little bit bigger than a 1 ounce taster, don't you say?
Amen. But we're home now. And if it wasn't for the 1 ounce tasters, we'd have been in trouble.
Well, we still got a few pours at the 2 ounce line, I tell you that.
And at the Stone, that's another thing. Listening to Stone. By the way, I got to do one other thing, though, before we get going. Having said these are great guys, this last week, October 10th, was a grand, grand day.
Grand day.
The 1 year. Can you believe it's only 1 year that's been around?
I still think that his math is fuzzy. I don't know.
Nope, SJ said it himself. The 1 year anniversary of Homebrew Wednesdays. So with that,
cheers.
Big cheers to you,
cheers
SJ.
To that. I mean,
big cheers.
Cheers. It's hard to think that when us noobs came on and we're like, let's do this Homebrew Wednesday thing, just like a couple of idiots, that we weren't that far behind, and
no.
A whole bunch of you weren't either.
No, we started in February of 2012. So now we've got to give the biggest, biggest shout out of all. This, of course, is going to S.J. Poor.
Yes.
The father of Homebrew Wednesday.
Yes.
The 10th of October is celebrating, he says, the 1 year anniversary of Homebrew Wednesday. Can you believe that?
No. No,
we,
I can't.
We noobs, we started in February. Wow. SJ, what an amazing thing you've done. I'm sure you're probably amazed yourself. You've got people globally joining in. And so it's huge. And what a great community. We thank you. We
yes.
say cheers to you.
Cheers to you. I was getting thirsty.
Yes.
And I thought Dad was going to celebrate that I was growing out my hair again. I guess that's a little bit more impressive than my hair.
It is. And so while we sit here and drink our Maharaja, thank you again, BH, check this out.
The goal of the next meeting is to get their deals, you know, show them all the types of things that we may be able to do, and that's what I think it makes it better to have some kind of printed policy.
Look at this, Clement's Homebrew, MaximAvs, it's the photo line agreement.
all him, but I'm just saying. It doesn't get much better than this.
Went to the brewery. What was this one?
Smoking Wood.
Oh my god.
All of that. I just got a sour. It's making me a little bitter beer base.
We're going to have to get back early because they're serving some Black Tuesday at 8 o'clock.
Fuck yeah.
Yeah.
Black Tuesday.
Told you, but I have some Irish in me as well.
Yes.
Cement floor, and you go, and then you can hear it throughout the place, and everyone goes,
tink.
Oh! It's drunk people everywhere, so
it's throughout the place. It's just like a wave in a baseball stadium or a football stadium.
It's something that everyone should do once in their life. I probably will go back again because I think it was really hard.
I put my cup in this. and it fell out once, so I got oat as well.
Yeah, watch out, you know.
Come Saturday, though, man, they get wasted fast. The oat started within 10 minutes or something of opening.
Oh, I think someone dropped it. I think they were drunk with their car. Oh, shit. So.
Well, hopefully, pun intended, you got a taste of what the Great American Beer Fest is like.
Crazy.
But that wasn't the whole weekend.
No.
We got so much more. Let us show you some of our fun at Avery Brewing.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, baby.
Okay, coming at you.
I'm a homebrew.
At the Avery Brewing.
Indeed.
Oh, yes.
What have you got there?
I have the 2011 Beast off tap, just 16.83%.
Lightweight. I've got the Uncle Jacob's Stout at 17.42.
Geez, like
0.75%. Amazing.
I don't even know what to say.
We'll be drinking.
Cheers, guys.
So, again, thank you guys so much for coming out to Avery. How many of you guys have been here before?
Nope.
Welcome back. Nice. How many of you guys have had Avery beer before today? Sweet. Anyone homebrew, brewer, work in the industry? Anyone of you guys? Anyone single? Let's see what you got. I want this to be like a fun and interactive tour for you guys, so if at any point you're thinking, talk to you later. Which means we were started back in 1993, and we're a small family-owned company that was started by two gentlemen, Adam Avery and his father, Larry. And back in 93, Adam was in his mid to late 20s and he was going through what he called a quarter life crisis because he didn't have a real job or a real career or any sort of long-term goal. So it's kind of a stressful period for him. He's like, what am I going to do with my life? What am I going to be? He was homebrewing an awful lot, cycling around a lot. And from what I understand, he was thinking of pursuing law school, but luckily he had a few lawyer buddies that kind of talked him out of it. They're like, you know what? We know you, Adam. Plus you wouldn't be happy doing this kind of work. And you're doing a whole lot of awesome homebrew. What if you started up a brewery? So back in 93, there were not too many craft breweries around at that point. So they were kind of supporting him, encouraging him. And then around the same time, his father, Larry, was going into retirement. And somehow, Adam was able to convince Larry to invest all of his retirement money to starting up. Very risky situation. I think he got about $90,000 up front of money that's not guaranteed to come back. So they both kind of worked their butts off. I think that was probably a big motivator for them. Because if you fail or the business goes under, it means you're going to live with your dad for a long time. So you better man. But this is the original site where we started here, this one warehouse. And we have slowly grown and expanded from here. But as you'll get to see, we're still a very small kind of garage-style operation. We only have about 7 of these warehouses along here. There's even a business in between here and the tap room that has nothing to do with it. But I think we're pretty cool neighbors to have. but yeah, still, I don't know where I was going. It's been a long weekend of drinking, guys. We did struggle the first 6 years or so, almost went under at a couple points, but we were able to kind of slowly pull through that and get to where we're at today. Thanks to awesome individuals like yourselves who enjoy full-flavored beer, so cheers to that.
Cheers.
Cheers. So, we have a series of beers that we call our Holy Trinity of Ales, which is Salvation, Reverend, Hog Heaven. Those beers are all 9 to 10% alcohol. We have our Dictator series, which is the Maharaja, the Tsar, the Kaiser. Those are 9 to 11% alcohol, which is pretty strong. Those beers can take 2 to 3 weeks easily inside these tanks to ferment condition before they're ready to package. But we're pretty sick here. We don't just stop there. We also have a series of beers that we call our Demons of Ale. How many of you guys have had a demon beer? A fair amount of you. Awesome. So if you're not familiar with the Demons of Ale, there's 3 different beers in this series. Beast, which is out right now, the Mephistopheles, which will come out in December. We have the 2011 on tap, though. And then the Sam Ales, which comes out in April. And they're all very different beers. But the defining characteristic between them, why we call them Demons of Ale, is that they're all between 15 and 18% alcohol, which is ridiculously strong. Definitely pushes the boundaries of what you might call a beer and even starts to taste more like a port or a dessert wine or a diluted whiskey at that point. But those beers, they can take 2 to 3 months inside these tanks to fully ferment and condition before they're actually ready to package up. We actually have bottles of a beer for sale called Rumpkin that we just released for the third time, which is an imperial Imperial Pumpkin Ale that we brewed with allspice, nutmeg, cinnamon, pumpkin rinds, and then took it and aged it in fresh Gosling's black rum barrels for 6 months. So this is like the most big badass pumpkin beer you've had. It comes in at 18.1%. So, box for sale. Check it out. Talk to me later.
Yeah,
we got. So this is our bottling line where we package up a whole lot of our beer. It's this big piece of equipment that starts here, wraps around the room, and ends right behind you guys. This was about a $700,000 investment for the brewery. It's custom made in Italy for us, and we acquired this early 2006. So didn't have it right away. It used to be Adam and Larry hand filling and capping all the bottles. I believe they had an intermediate piece of equipment. Yeah, it's very tedious
in the world?
Process. I'm sure if you guys have ever tried it, it's hard work. It takes a long time.
I have tried it.
But so we got this 2006, but when it came over, it was shipped from Italy. It came in about 100,000 different little pieces with an instruction booklet, all in Italian. That didn't include any pictures either, which is pretty ridiculous because I think we had maybe like just
translation.
No,
get you down the corner.
Translation. So we had maybe 12 people on staff at the time. Not one of them speaking a lick of Italian.
Hey everyone, we're here at Avery with Big Walt, and we got a big beer, and he's going to tell us about it.
So, this is a 2009 Mephistopheles Imperial Stout, and it's from Adam Avery's Christmas.
You know, I gotta say, it's beer to brewer, I guess you're right about us. You're hoity-toity.
Yes, thank you.
I'm gonna go get my hoity-toity on.
What you got, Christian?
Crazy Frank's great.
Foolish Craig's.
Yeah, Foolish Craig's, whatever it is. It's fantastic, and it's especially great with bacon. And it's an egg on top of a grape, and it's fantastic.
I've got the BLT guacamole, which was featured on Diners, Drive-Ins, and Dives. Life's good.
That was one heavy hitting alcohol hardcore day.
Yes.
And first I'm going to say our apologies. When we went there, they only allow one rumpkin per person. So I know people are hoping to get bottles. It's just
it's not
going to happen. We will be reviewing one. And the new rumpkin, if you caught that, is an 18.1%.
18.1!
Oh my lord.
You're gonna get trashed!
And we're looking forward to that beer review.
Oh, yeah.
The other thing I've got.
We should review too!
This bottle is going into our wall of fame of beers. And you saw a little clip of that, but what an awesome bottle that is!
Yeah.
So that's the Mephistopheles Stout.
That's the 2009.
The 2009.
Yeah, straight from
Adam Avery's private cellar.
Because he was so excited about the Brewfest this year, he wanted to open up his private cellar.
You cannot walk the bottle out. It has to be consumed on site, so these can never auction off for big amounts.
And those fantastic, awesome chalices, those things were heavy.
And I know somebody can say this is outrageous, Kevin, but for something coming from an owner's cellar, this was $16. I think that was a steal.
No. $14. Even better.
Was it 14?
It was 14.
Yeah, we could have gotten the 2006. That one was 24, so we backed off. But
we had to get t-shirts.
Yeah, and then we had to go to Crazy Craig's and get that awesome food.
Yeah, that's true.
Nice place. So now, to top everything off, as fun as all that was, and it was really, really fun.
It's tiring, though, too.
It is tiring.
I mean, it's really hard to just go drink all day
and then drink that night.
And drink more.
But it got better. It got better because then we went over to a restaurant that was by Oscar Blues. Yep. Had a nice lunch with Emo, DJ the Chef, and BH, of course.
Mm-hmm.
went back to BH's house, where MaximAvs joined us in the man cave that you've watched him building on his videos.
Oh, yes.
So you get to see a little clip of guys enjoying each other, a shot of the man cave, and a big cheers to y'all then. Yeah. Check this out. Good times.
Famous one. You are the most famous one. There he is. He's hiding. Yes.
The only video I'm prevalent in on my YouTube channel is when I got my last haircut.
It's a historic moment.
We are at the pad of BH Brewing. This is a man cave.
There's gotta be something. Somebody's gotta be playing.
What?
Yeah, the early game should be just about ended. Later game should be just
about ended. Oh, there's. Yeah. It's either gonna be on Fox or. I don't think ESPN takes them over yet.
All last weekend.
Fox on now.
All last weekend, it was nothing but football. Like every channel was football. It was awesome. Yeah.
This week's got a lot of buys, though. I have a missed call.
Alright. You want to bust out one of them now? You want to wait?
Sure. No, go for it.
Which one is it?
I want feedback from people, so I'd rather have sober feedback than drunk feedback.
Which one is it?
Either one, Grit Honey or Grit. Yeah, there's two of them. Two Grits.
There you go.
But I assume that depends on the alpha level of the
bitterness.
Of what you put in.
Well, it depends on when you put them in.
Yeah, when and
I,
what.
I think you used more on the it's more of a pale than a called an IPA.
Okay.
But I would think that for you suits you better too.
It does, yeah, because like I said, I'm not an IPA guy. Yeah. I'm not, you know, a hop head. It was like a little more bitter than I'm used to.
Mm-hmm.
But so then that's why it throws my taste buds all off. Trying to classify beers because I'm
It's almost more like an ESB than it is a pale.
Yeah, because there's the sweet.
It's got that. A lot of bitterness, but no flavor and aroma on the hops, which I like. That's what I would.
That was the confusion for me. I'm like, well, I don't.
But
smell
where I would think that if I was going to call this an IPA, it could have the same bittering in it, but I think the hops would be more prevalent in the aroma and flavor.
But your knowledge.
And it's actually my dad's recipe.
No, it tastes. To me, it tastes.
And I was trying to follow suit with him to see if I could duplicate it.
Yeah, but then you have the whole, like, is it an English style pale or an American style pale? Like, if you want to look at an English style pale, like, you'd be looking at Boddington's or like Bass, which is absolutely nothing like an American style pale.
I think that's what the Stone guy said, is like they were like saying, it's like, are you fearful of change and everything? He's like, right, I welcome new categories of beer because I can actually then categorize some of the beer that we're brewing. Yeah. It's like, you can't categorize this stuff because it's like, it doesn't meet the parameters of anything in that category.
Yeah, are you,
like
are the, you brewing to win contest or are you brewing to please yourself? And it was the same thing for the guys at Stone. You make to please yourself. Inevitably, you're going to find people that love what you're doing.
Yeah.
So I really like that philosophy.
Well,
it's
kind of like the Gruyt. You can't really. It's not tea. It's not beer. It's not wine. It's not mead. It's kind of somewhere in the middle of all that, and it's not remotely like any of them. And like, and how do you describe that to somebody, or how do you classify it? And then the Gruyt that I made versus the Gruyt that I hope you guys get to taste from Hockey.
Versus
what SJ Poor and Warrior and Hen and Arrogant Bastardale are gonna do. Like, I bet you all of those are different. Like, which one is more true to this style? It's, you know, it's like, well, hey, we all tried it to see if we can make something that would work. And what ultimately comes out of it, I think, would be more. You can't really classify. I can't classify that. It tastes so. Off the beaten path, you know?
I think it's cool how, like, you know, how evolution goes around, and now we're back to making Gruyts, right? That's
IPAs
a new thing,
or,
right? It's like.
And then you have beer for the next several hundred years only being made with hops. So.
I truly think,
from what I've seen, that this whole industry is really about homebrewers. It all grew out of homebrewers. It's totally charged by homebrewers. And other people have joined in, but I think it's the fact that average people can participate and be creative and have fun and
try something new.
Yeah. And it's created this community that's just really awesome.
Kevin, Clements Homebrew.
Daniel, DJ the Chef.
Sean, MaximAvs.
Christian, Clements Jr.
Immolauteus.
BHbrewing.
You know, Hockey, we all wish you were here. Screw you, Hockey.
Cheers.
Cheers. Cheers. Enjoy the fruits of your labor.
SJ Larmo, we wish you were here.
Poor Hockey.
Poor Hockey.
Good times with the guys. I do got to say one thing. So, Hockey, you know, we poke fun at you all the time. We know you love you. But the thing is when we got onto the driveway at the end, what was it that everyone was saying? I'll see you on Saturday night.
Yeah, that's true. That's true.
So, we thank you. We thank you. This is another plug. Justin TV, Hockey Player. Have it down in the credit areas below. Tune in. It's someplace that we all meet and chat together.
There might be the rare appearance of Clements Jr.
It might just have to be. Maybe. But I will make it a point to be there this coming Saturday. What can I say? These guys are awesome.
Yeah, and I would just like to say thank you guys. I consider you guys friends already. And it's really just... we appreciated it, and you guys know that anytime you want to come over and visit us,
we have extra
it's
rooms.
Open. It's open.
Yeah,
for sure.
We would. It would be the greatest pleasure ever for any of you to come out, and that includes so many of you out there. You're coming to Portland. We'd love to host you, or at least meet up with you and take you around. That's the coolest thing on earth is meeting part of the clan. Oh, do you like my hat, by the way? That was kind of fun. A homebrew hat. Had to have that in there. So now...
Oh, put the hat back on.
Ooh. Yikes. So now... So a couple quick shout-outs. We've got to do it.
Yeah.
Our biggest and first is a shout-out to all our new subscribers. We had quite a few while we were gone. It's amazing.
Wow.
A couple fun ones. Noobster12, who apparently laughed his ass off, and we hope you were able to reattach that.
Yes, please do. It'd be a tough time watching the rest of our videos without that.
And to Dennis Cannon, who said we look like stars. I think we look better on video, but...
I don't know.
What do you think?
I mean, I look taller, that's for sure. I really pump out my chest and...
But thanks, Dennis. We take all these things with a grain of salt. If you got a contract for us and you're in the industry, let us know. We'd love to change careers.
Oh, yeah, you know, I don't have to, you know, push paper anymore at Fred Meyer. I could definitely do this for a living.
Another couple quickies. First of all, to Everdy, now Everdy Homebrewing, used to be Everdy Studios. We got your package safely. That will be shown on the next Homebrew Wednesday. We'll just say Red Solo Cup. And then and another thing that was a crack up for us was Everdy was actually listening to BN, Beer Network, and actually wrote me and said, was that Christian on Beer Network Live at the Great American Beer Fest talking about mixing beers?
No, that was Dad. Sorry, we saw
actually,
him the same.
Actually, he rose his hand first. We had to chase the gal down. We do sound a lot on when you don't see us on screen. Yeah. And but yes, that was our joint question about mixing Ruination 10th Anniversary Ruination.
That was Dad's excited voice. If my excited voice was on there, it would have been, hey, have you guys missed the brews? I get really high-pitched when I'm excited, okay? I just, woo! So it was good. But I made sure I gave that big old thumbs up when Dad said, I was like, you gotta try it.
Yeah, and we did have a fun time because we got to talk to Greg afterwards. And what a funny, funny, nice man. Very, very cool. Greg Koch. Also, too, a quickie out there to say... Anthony, we got your package. We will pull that out on camera next week.
Yeah.
Bearded Brewer, back in the news with shout-outs. Dan, Imperial Pumpkin, nice. Beer trade is on.
Oh,
we want the Imperial.
You know whose pumpkin that you're going to be challenged to beat is BH's pumpkin. That
damn
is a good
straight
pumpkin ale.
Shout out to BH because he had a freaking ale. Actually, BH's pumpkin ale for standard pumpkin ale, I think, was better than any commercial one I've had. I can't put it past the Imperials. But my God.
That was a good pumpkin.
That was, that one, I think, that was like an 89 for me. That was good.
Yeah.
And also, too, we want to throw out there, one more thing, Barry Brewer. What's this, papers on space-aged solar energy? Holy flying space cows. You are a smart dude.
Space-based solar... They get sun out there?
You'll have to talk to my other son who works in solar technology. And another one to Jamison Moeckel. I don't know if Jamison will ever see this, but he does beer reviews, Tantrum 777. He made a double IPA, which included a first wort hopping. And we'll include a link below. I'd never heard of first wort hopping. What an awesome thing. So I'm going to show this stuff to Christian because... when we make our double Imperial IPA, that's going to be part of it to give more layers. And then final one that we're going to throw out there is our pimping of the week. Dun, da, da, da.
Dun, da, da, da.
And that's to Paul Wickenstein, who's from New Zealand. He's originally a home brewer. He's starting his own pico-brewery. And he is selling t-shirts to raise money to help grow the pico-brewery. You really got to see stuff on his videos because he has some great, great information. Very knowledgeable fellow. And let's support him going forward.
Yeah.
Paul, awesome video. You got one more up I haven't seen yet. You're number 3, and I'll be watching that soon. So I'm sure I'm going to be buying a t-shirt from Paul soon and sporting it.
Yes.
But awesome, awesome. We love seeing guys go pro. We're whipping this all in quick because we know there's been a long, long video. But from Clement's Homebrew.
Yes. We're coming at you every week.
Every
from
week.
Homebrew Wednesday. From here on out.
We just not quitting, baby.
No. This is happening.
Love this family here we got. Cheers to you all. We'll catch you on another Homebrew Wednesday.